morning, everyone. So it is about 5 in the morning, and after an eventful night yesterday to make it here, we're finally getting ready to go to La Sierra Nevada del Cocuy. It's in the clouds right now, but actually it is full of glaciers, of incredible glaciers, actually the largest glaciated area here in Colombia. So it will be a very long day. We have about 16 kilometers to cover and 1,000 meters of elevation to cross. But we'll manage, and we'll install an NLAPS, a Tiki from the company NLAPS, to monitor the changes of the glaciers over the next few years. So very excited. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm here with Nina, and we're making good progress. But today is not a race. Today is a marathon. We have to survive to the long distance we have to cover, and we're at about 3,800 meters of elevation, and we are crossing probably one of the most spectacular places we have seen on this trip to Colombia. And that is this valley. It's called the Valley of the Frailejones. And I'm sorry for my pronunciation, it's probably not great. But these are these trees that we saw on the first day when we went to Santa Isabel. You see all of them. And I remember seeing something similar on Kilimanjaro, but they are everywhere and they're really beautiful. So we're about 4,300 meters, and it's been very steep, very steep, because we were down there an hour ago in the Valley of the Frailejones, and now here we gain 500 meters very, very quickly. Stings a bit at this altitude, but we're doing very good. And better news, the clouds are lifting up, so I'm really hoping that we'll have a good view of the glaciers. It's been very wet during the night, it's very humid and very warm, but hopefully we're gonna have a lucky day. Oh my god, we're starting to see the glaciers. I'm trying to rush to make the most of this little window and try to install the time-lapse camera, install the Tiki, and do a little bit of droning. That'd be very nice. So we have arrived in the amphitheater of glaciers. I mean, it is just beyond this world. Unbelievable. And what we're doing is actually trying to make the most of the weather window to find a good place for the Tiki, because that's very important. And it's quite a touristy place here. But Jorge, who is Let me see up there. Yeah, you can see in here. It's found a good spot. So hopefully we'll install it there. But it's a bit tricky and everything is moving around here, so I hope it will be stable. So here is the tiki that will have the chance to stay here for probably 2 years at least to monitor the glaciers behind us. So we've just set it up. Pictures every 2 hours from 6 in the morning to 6 in the evening. And the guys are building a super strong foundation, super strong tripod. So this is not going to go anywhere. And the battery is already 100% again. I mean, the solar radiation is so strong. Can't wait to see where this goes. So that's it, we're leaving with Nina. We're super ready, the camera is installed, the camera is working. So it was a bit sad to leave it here.
Yeah.
But we've heard the glacier growling so much.
It was amazing.
I think it's gonna capture quite some great images. Thank you, Enlabs, for your support. Doing good work.
Thank you so much.